Hello everyone, greetings from India. I represent the Foundation for Genetic Resources, Energy, Ecology and Nutrition with an acronym GREEN. We are all aware that globally agricultural biodiversity is shrinking and disappearing at an alarming rate. As quoted by Biodiversity International, out of a total of 250,000 known plant species, approximately 7,000 have been identified for human food. Since the origin of agriculture, out of these, just 12 crops and 5 animal species provide the 3/4 of world's food today. Farmers in the world, small farmers, have played a significant role in conserving the diversity despite the onslaught of wheat and rice during the Green Revolution period. There is a growing awareness amongst farmers to maintain the diversity, which is the basis of food security in the light of population growth and climate change. Green Foundation's efforts in the last 2 decades has focused on establishing community seed banks as an important step towards conserving diversity in the rain-fed regions of Karnataka, where the agro-ecological zones have the potential for crops that can withstand climate change. In Green Foundation, we have emphasized on community seed banks, which is a system in the process of community agriculture. Through this system, farmers have played a key role in the creation, maintenance, and promotion of crop genetic diversity. They have also established their own seed networks to supply their seeds to their community. Community seed banks are one of the major challenges for maintaining the genetic diversity in crop species. There have been various pieces of legislation in India, such as the Plant Variety Protection and Farmers' Right Act, the Biodiversity Act, Patent Act, and the Seed Law, which is yet to be passed as an act. There remains an urgent need to integrate and harmonize the various pieces of legislation related to crop genetic diversity and the access and benefit sharing mechanisms. Particularly, the bureaucratic and complex procedures of crop variety registration in the Plant Variety Protection and Farmers' Right Act is simply impractical for farmers who are illiterate, do not have access to internet or means of traveling to the various government departments. As a consequence, the official benefit-sharing regimes are completely inaccessible for a large number of farmers. This apart, the variety registration requirement outlined by the Act is contradictory to preserving crop diversity, like the dust characteristics. Land races are valued for their ability to adapt to changing environmental conditions and rarely are genetically homogeneous. A standard model for variety registration and benefit sharing is detrimental to conserving diversity. What are the lessons that we can derive from the community seed banks? The seed banks that are well organized show that the informal benefit sharing structures present an effective alternative to government regulated access benefit sharing institutions. The key elements that contribute to its success include offering farmers incentives to cultivate traditional or rare varieties, providing assistance in the marketing of their produce, and encourage traditional technologies associated with indigenous crops. To make access and benefit sharing relevant to the situation of small farmers, it is necessary to ensure community ownership and protect farmers' rights over the genetic diversity within the seed banks. There should also be a way of recognizing women's right to knowledge of plant genetic resources within the new system that patent, privatize, or compensate knowledge and genetic resources. Finally, I wish to express my heartfelt thanks to ILEA for having given me this opportunity to share our field experiences. And for more information, I request you to visit www.greenconserve.com. Thank you.